Today we are going to start a new unit, that is unit 3. Okay, so unit 3 we will be going for the PHP. Okay, PHP and MySQL. So you can see the not unit 3, it is unit 4. Unit 3 is Ajax. This is 3 to 4 classes required for complete this Ajax. But I felt I should finish unit 4 first. Then I will have to go for this unit 3. And there is a small part of this unit 2 is pending. That is sex. This is one of the parser is also there. So this is a Java based parser. It is for parsing this XML. The thing is that previously also we are using a number of parser for doing that one. Maybe DOM also we are using. But here, instead of loading the entire XML file, just we go for parsing by part. We can do all the things here. Okay. So this is the thing that I will explain in one class. I will take for this sex. Today it is not possible for you. Then coming to this Ajax, this is asynchronous Java. That also I'm not going to take it now. Maybe after completion of the fourth unit, what is happening? Most of the people, they are only focusing the 3 units and they are not focusing the remaining units, especially the below average students. But remember, the last 3 units are very important for you, for your career and for the web page design. Especially the PHP and MySQL is most important. So I thought in unit 3, I will cover the entire thing in details, and 3 classes is enough to complete the unit regarding the XML and this Ajax, this part, that is the part. Then we will be studying in details regarding the Perl and Ruby. Okay, Perl and Ruby, now Ruby the latest thing, Ruby on Rails, the platform also you are using. It is very important for you. But what I am telling you that as a computer science student, everyone must focus on this PHP and MySQL. Okay, so that's why it is very important, and I am covering this first. Okay, now we come to this PHP, and as I told you that it is part of this unit 4. This is the acronym for this PHP Hypertext Preprocessor. Okay, so then it is widely used, and it is open source also, and it is used as a scripting language. You remember previously we know something about the Java scripting. It is a client side, and sometimes also you can use, but this PHP is a server side scripting, and it is a very good scripting language also. There are a lot of advantages of this PHP, and it is very simple also, remember, and it is open source. There is no need to purchase any license software for that one. You can download free of cost, and you can install the JAM server, and you can also do all this PHP program there. Okay, so first of all, these PHP scripts are executed on the server. This is the server side scripting language, and it is free to download and use. So there is no issue of license here. So we can freely and comfortably use this PHP. Then what can PHP do? So if it is, I am telling that this is the PHP, this is open source, it is a scripting language, it is running in server side. Okay, it is up to this, it is nice. Then what is the purpose of this PHP, or what the PHP can do? It can generate dynamic page contents. So our HTML is purely static. When you go for this dynamic page content, we have to use either the JavaScript or the PHP. JavaScript, it being a client side, it is better we go for this PHP. Okay, then another, so there are so many other advantages. This PHP can create, it can open, it can read, write, delete, and close files on the server. So through this PHP also, you can do all this work there. Then it can collect form data. Suppose you are submitting some data in a form, because from the client side, through a form, you submit all the data. So this PHP can collect all this data from this form. That is one of the advantages. And it can also send and receive cookies. That is information about other systems, that what we call it, the cookies. It can send cookies, and also it can receive cookies. Then it has a very good thing that it can add, it can delete and modify data in your database. And it supports a number of databases. So it is not one, two, a number of databases it supports. That we'll see in the next PHP, we'll see. Then the other thing is that it can use to control user access also, and it can also encrypt the data. That encryption part is also there. That we'll study in detail how it goes for the user control, user access control, then how to encrypt all the things, how you send cookies, how to create a cookies and how to close. All the things we'll study in details in this PHP. Because what is happening, the time I will be starting fourth unit, then most of the people, they are irregular. So, and they never focus on this PHP and MySQL. Last time happened the same thing. So I decided in the third unit, I will complete thoroughly. If it is necessary, 8 to 10 hours class I will take. for completing the PHP and MySQL in details. Then we'll go for this Ajax, because Ajax is hardly four classes, 3 to 4 classes, 4 hours class is enough to complete entire thing. I'll be giving a demonstration and how to run this program, that also I'll explain. Okay, don't worry for that one at this moment. Then why PHP? You see the advantages. PHP can generate dynamic page content, that is number one. Sorry, PHP runs on various platform like Windows, Linux, Unix, Mac, and all the things it runs. Then it is compatible with all the servers, but specially we'll be using on Apache or IIS. Okay, and we'll be using Apache because what I told you that I am downloading and installing XAMPP. In that XAMPP, by default, Apache is there. Okay, this MySQL, Apache, MySQL, all things will find. Okay, then PHP support a wide range of databases also. So whatever the database it is available, that is also okay. So it is so something somebody is giving the wrong thing. PHP supports a wide range of databases. Then it is free and we can download from this website, www.php.net. So it is free, just we go there, you can download, but don't go for that one. I will tell you that you have to go for XAMPP. First you have to see what is the your system configurations. Based on that configurations, you have to download the XAMPP and you have to install and see that you don't have WhatsApp, because by default that the port number 80 will be assigned to WhatsApp. If you have WhatsApp, you just remove that one. Then firstly you install that one, because by default it will be occupying 80. Otherwise there is a procedure to assign the port number 8080. Okay, that is another thing. But XAMPP, how to install and how to run, that I will tell you later on. Now I am telling you that we can download and install XAMPP for the Windows version. If you are using Windows system, if you are using Linux, you can go for that XAMPP Linux version also. Mac also you can do. All are available and all are strictly free. And it is very easy to learn and runs effectively or efficiently on the server side also. So these are the advantages why we will go for PHP. Is it clear? So again, I'm repeating, for generating dynamic page content, we need the PHP, and it is a server side scripting language. It supports almost all the databases, and we can update everything on the database using this PHP also. And also it can open, read, write, and delete all the files in the server also. You remember, file is there in the server, you can do all the things here from this place also, writing the PHP program. So these are the reasons. And another thing is that it for running these things, because after you write a program or after you do things, what you need to do, you go for deployment all the things. For deployment all the things, we need the server, we use the Apache or use the IIS. IIS is by default with the Microsoft, it is available. But whenever you want to run on these things, your XAMPP, we need Apache, and by default Apache will be there. Okay, so this is the advantages of all the things. Then immediately we are going for some program for that one. Okay, now let us go to our first program on PHP. How to write a program on PHP? Okay, so all the students, small announcement is there, because all the first day I will be there in the college, and the college, the network problem is there. That's why this Thursday classes I will be taking on Wednesday 4 to 5, and the same slot Thursday Dr. Deva Balan will be taking the classes. There is a small things, and I will be sharing with all the things also. And I tell you that these classes are very important, and I will be running very slowly for you all. Yeah, somebody have a doubt, what is the question? Yeah, okay sir, thank you. So then what okay, so now our thing is that how to write this PHP program, and how we can make it dynamic. See, initially I am writing this PHP program inside my HTML. For writing a HTML program, it is damage, less than exclamatory doc type is equal to HTML, doc type HTML, and we start the HTML, close HTML, body, opening tag body and closing tag body. For writing a PHP program, this is the line which is very much important, you have to remember. So less than question mark PHP, then something will be there inside, then at the end you are writing question mark and greater than. Okay, so this is the thing, less than question mark PHP, and at the end I am putting question mark and greater than sign. So with this, your browser will understand that it is a PHP program, and by default it will run this one. Okay, and I am telling you that it is compatible with the HTML also. So what I told that your XML, that whatever the program you are writing in PHP, it will also run under this HTML. There is no problem on that one. So now I am going to write my first program on my first program here. So that is the my first PHP script, or I want to say hello, final year C student, something that I want to write that. Then what you have to do? So what is the print command you are putting it there? Here I am writing echo, echo, and after that whatever things are there, it should be under double quotations my first PHP script, and then at the end you have to put a semicolon. So this is the syntax, the rule you have to remember. So less than question mark PHP, then echo space under double quotations, what we want to display, it will be displayed there. Then put a semicolon at the end, and then you enter all the things. Okay, this is your program. Then how to run all this program? You might see this program is available here, PH1. What is the file name here? You see this file name is PH1 dot PHP. PH1 dot PHP. So it will not run. This run like this by double clicking. It will not run. Suppose you double click this file PH1 dot PHP. It won't run. Then how it will run? So for running all the things, what you need to do? We have to. Anyway, here I think there's no such thing. Okay. For then for what I have to do? So I go for this XAMPP, XAMPP. This XAMPP already I installed. Okay. Just I am going to this XAMPP control. You can see the XAMPP control. The installation is in one more CD. I'll show you. It is easy. You can download and you can install there also. So I have already installed. When you double click there, this XAMPP server, you can see. I think there will be some problem. If you run this XAMPP server, this networking will be disconnected. Okay. So anyway, let me try also. But in the meantime, if you get disconnected, don't worry. Again, I will start and show you all things. Okay. So I start the Apache. I told you that I need Apache for running this PHP program, and also for running my PHP, my SQL program, I need the MySQL. And you see, here it is supporting Apache. Here it is supporting MySQL, FileZilla, Mercury, Tomcat. All the things it is supporting. Okay. So suppose I want to run this PHP program. For the PHP is inbuilt with this Apache. Then I have to start it here. Once I start it here, you see it is going, the PID is this one, and the port is taking 8080. Okay. So now 8080 port, because by default it is supposed to take this 80, because I am using some other applications. So they already occupied 80. So I already assigned the port number 8080. Okay. So this is the PID for Apache, and this is the port number I have given, 8080. But remember, by default the port number 80 is assigned to Apache. Similarly, if you want to run this MySQL also, just start this one. See, here also, this is 3306 is the port number it is given for this MySQL. Okay, we minimize all the things. Now to see that your file is running, what you need to do? Yeah, I think, yeah, I minimize this thing. Okay, don't worry for these things, let it be here. So now I go for my Google Chrome. I write the localhost, and what is the port number I have given? You remember it is 8080. Okay, then forward slash, then what is my file name? If you remember, it was ph1.php. okay, ph1.php. now let us run. What is the output? What has to be displayed? My first PHP. My first PHP. Or you want to change that program. Suppose I want to change this program. Hello, final year CSC students. Just I want to change that one. Welcome to PHP program. Okay. Hello, final year CSC students. Welcome to PHP program. Control S. So this is my file. I saved it here also. Then I am going to run the same file here. Okay. Yeah. Just you refresh it. Control S, just I save it. Control S, I saved it. Okay, then I am refreshing this one. Still it is not taking. Okay, then again I have to run it back ph1.php. okay, then enter. What happened? Same thing now. What is the file name here? ph1.php. what I have given here, I don't understand these things. Now you go for localhost and at the end you give /ph1.php. okay, enter. Still it is showing my first PHP script. I don't know, some error somewhere, but it should run and it show the output PHP echo. okay, all the things. Hello, final year CSE students, welcome to file save. Okay, control S. okay, now I come to this one, your file here, then you go to this one. I do not know why, what is the problem is there, but it will run and it will show the output. So there is nothing to worry. Maybe it is creating some problem because I am online, I am using this this video, and also at the same time using that port number. Maybe some error is showing, but it will run. There is no issue for that one. You can try whatever things you will be giving there, the same thing it will run also. Okay, maybe it is showing some error. Okay, now let us go to my second program. Now I go for the file. Then I open file. So I go for ph2.php. So this is the file I am going to open here. So here you see, I am using this PHP file inside the HTML. Okay, here the file is also same. I am writing with the <?PHP, and for writing the comments, if you want to use a single line comment, then /, whatever a single line you are writing. So I have written, this is a single line comment. Okay, if it is one line, just /. So if it is also another way there, you can use a hash sign and you can also use a single line comment for writing your comment inside the PHP. Either you can use for single line, you can use either a double /, or you can use a hash sign. But if you write multi line or multiple line comments, then you have to put it /*. Then whatever the lines you write it there, and the end you put a star and a /. Okay, you can also use comment to leave out part of these code lines. Okay, this part is there. Then I am writing it here. So for example, I am using this inside the, this is a coding was there, $x is equal to, that means I am declaring a variable x, that's why I'm writing $x. X is equal to 5 + 15 + 5. But I don't want to execute this part. Then what I did it, 5/*, up to this star and /. So this part it will not be used. Okay, then what is the output will be there? 5 + 5. So then you only echo $x, then the output it will be 10. Okay, let us see what is the output of this file. Now I am going to this one, then I am coming here and I am going to ph2.php. So output is 10. Can you see the output here? The output is also 10 here. Now in a similar manner, so this is what I explained to you, that is related to how to declare a variable and how to use that one. So now what I have done it here, in the first part I told you how to write a PHP, and don't worry for this HTML part. If you delete this HTML part also, it will still run because it is a PHP program and you are running it inside the htdocs folder of where it is there. You would remember. So whatever the PHP file you are writing, these files must be there inside the htdocs folder. Okay, I'll show you where is that folder and how it runs. So what is the file I am doing? These files will be there. You go to the C drive. You go to my PC. Okay, you then you go to the C drive, then you go to the C drive. In the C drive, you might have installed the XAMPP. When you install the XAMPP, I already installed the XAMPP here. Sorry, by default, the XAMPP will be installed in the C drive. Inside the XAMPP folder, there will be htdocs. Yeah, this folder, that is just like the root directory, and whatever the files you want to put it there, those files must be available here. Okay, so now all your files are available here, and we are talking about the PH1. Let me see whether this file is updated or not. So open with Sublime. Yeah, so here it is not updated, that's why it is not running. So what I've written there, hello, final year students, final year CSE students, hello, final year CSE students, you are most welcome come to the PSP program, ESP program. Okay, hello, final year CSE students, you are most welcome to the PSP program. Okay, then I control S1. Now you see when I'm running this file, because that I did not save it inside the htdocs, that is the error it was showing. So I am going to the ph1.psv, what I just updated now. Now see, hello, final year CSE students, you are most welcome to the PSP program. Can you see all these things? Okay, now here in this program, what I explained to you, that I'm going to tell you, I just explained, you write a PHP program. When anywhere you use any of the editor, you write a program with the extension .php. How to write a program, that I have already shown you. This program, what you are writing with the extension, so my first program was ph1.php. This file, you have to copy and paste it inside the htdocs. You have to copy and paste it inside the htdocs. Otherwise, what you need to do, then you can go to the CMD, you can go to the concern folder, just you know the procedure. You go to CMD, okay, enter, then you go to CD space forward slash, then you are already in C drive, then CD XAMPP, then you are already in the XAMPP, then you go to the CD htdocs, 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 okay, CD htdocs, okay. Now you are already in the htdocs. If you see the directory, what are available there, you can see this much files are there. So suppose I want to open this, are you able to see this in, or you know, increase the font also, control plus, yeah, I think, okay, don't worry. So now what I'll do it here, if you want to open a particular file, suppose I want to open that file number 2, that is ph2, okay, then what you need to do, subl sublime space ph2.php. This is my second program. Okay, this is the program which you have seen. Now, if you save it here, by default, it is saved inside the folder htdocs, that is inside the folder your node jump, which is there in the C drive. Okay, so what I did previously, I already created these files, but I saved it in another file, another folder, but I am supposed to save it under the htdocs folder. That is the reason it was not running. Now, first program, it has run successfully. This is the second program. In the second program, it is also a PHP file. And here, I have shown you how to write the comments. This is a single line comment. There are two ways. One is by putting 2 forward slash, or one is putting by a hash sign. So this part will not be executed. It will not run, okay? Then if it is multiple lines, also you can use all the things, forward slash, tab, then whatever the lines you put in between, then end the star and forward slash, okay? And suppose you want to use this comments inside the program, that means this part should not be executed. That also you can do inside the program, slash star plus whatever things are there. So this is the part between this forward slash, 2 forward slashes, this part will not be executed. That means this output for this file will be 5 plus 5, that will be stored in the variable x, and for declaring a variable, we have to start with the dollar sign. Whatever the variable you want to declare in PHP, it has to start with the dollar sign. Suppose I want to declare a name, so variable is name, so dollar name. which is equal to under something I write Gunamani. Then I put a semicolon at the end. Okay, this is the syntax you have to remember. Then you want to call that variable, then echo $x and semicolon. Then automatically it will come. Now already I have shown you the output for this file. So this output for this file will be 5 + 5. It is 10. Suppose I change these things. Suppose I change this thing and delete here also. What is the output? Back. Okay, and back also. Okay. Now control S. Now you tell me what is the output? Output will be 5 + 5, 10, 10 + 15, 25. Let us see whether 25 it is coming or any other error it is showing. So now we are going for this is the file name, program number one is there. So I am changing the program to program number two, PH2. Okay, it's not coming. Yeah, back to enter. See, it has come 25. You understand? Now, whenever you want to use a program or a line of code, inside that, if you want to skip some part, they can you put it inside the forward slash star and star forward slash. Inside that, it will be you can make it inactive. It will this part will never run. Okay. Now let us see. Go to our next program. That is the program I am going for, the program number three. For running this program number three, so open the file. Open file. So now I am opening ph3. Okay, ph3.php. Yeah, this file is there. ph3.php. Open. Now suppose I want to use some variable, and the same variable I have to use inside my program. So I used a variable. The variable name is text. So how will you use a variable? For declaring a variable, I have to use the dollar sign. So inside the PSV thing, I mean $txt. That means the name of the variable is txt. For using it inside the PSV file, you have to use a dollar sign. Then what you assign to that one? BBC Engineering College. Under double quotations at the end, I put a semicolon. Then echo I love dollar text. That means I am calling that. I am calling that by variable. So I love that particular. What is the variable text? What is the content of that variable? It is BBC Engineering College. Now you guess and tell me what is the output? Yes. What is the output? Output will be that I love BBC Engineering College. Let us see whether the output is coming or not. Yeah, somebody I think raised a question. Refresh once. Okay. Now, are you able to see CLEA clearly? Down. Okay. So I think some, yes, sir. Okay. Thank you. So now I have some network problem here. That is the main reason, because that is the main, we have something and three people are using that network problem. So now you declare any variable here. Instead of text, you use X, you use Y, you use name, you use the college name, whatever the name you want to use it here with the dollar sign, that is declared as a variable. Okay. I have used the word txt text. So this is a text. So BBC Engineering College, and this variable text, which is equal to, you have to assign some value. I have under double quotation, I have assigned BBC Engineering College, and I love dollar text. Now I'm going to run this program. Now come here. What is the program name here? PH3. Okay. So come here and go to PH3. Okay. So back, I put 3 and enter. I love BBC Engineering College. Can you see all the things? The miracle of PHP. Now I will ask you some questions. I will ask you some questions, because I think out of 106 students, only 27 people are present, and out of that, so many people are also inactive, as if they are born with PHP certificates with them, PHP and MySQL. So if that is the case also, I am the happiest person. Remember that 12 mark questions you are getting in the university for this PHP and MySQL, and most important thing is that how many marks you are getting, that not important. As a computer science students, if you do not know, as a computer science students, if you do not know PHP MySQL, you do not know anything about this web technology or website design. Okay, so that's why it is very important for you. And even if it is in the fourth unit, I started in the third unit. Okay, and I will be setting question in the first media exam from this unit only, not for the your Ajax. Ajax I will put it in the second media exam. First media exam, it will be your HTML part, what I have explained till now. Then the second part will be the XML and one XSD program. And let me thank all the students. There is around 126 views for this XSD, but I do not know how many CSE people, because by mistake I sent it for the entire college. In one day there is 126 views are there, but it is a state of sorrow. Nobody subscribed it, and nobody, very few people have subscribed, and few people even if they forgot to put a like or dislike like that. So I appeal you that you subscribe, because there are so many other videos also I'm uploading. By default you can access, that is the thing. And we need more number of subscription for that also, because we have to provide to the give it the data to the chairman also. Okay, so my sincere request to all of you, you watch this video and recommend to the students who are absent for the today class also, because the same class I will not be repeating again and again. Okay, so preparing one class, you will see I'm not using the PowerPoint presentation to teach you theoretically. What I am executing in my program and my application software, same thing only I'm showing to you. I'm not telling you stories here. Clear? So it will be difficult for me to repeat the same thing again and again. Okay. Now it's good. Now you come to the program number four. Okay, I told you that I will ask you some question. Thing is that two or three questions are there. How do we deploy one PHP program? How to write a PHP program? Now you understand, because you start with a less than question mark PHP, and whatever the inside you write echo, and under double quotation something you write, and at the end you put a semicolon. Then this is the PHP program is ready. Then how to deploy all the things? Remember, for deploying this PHP by double clicking it will not run. You have to deploy these things. For deploying you need one of the server. You have two options with you. You can go for the IIS, or that is Internet Information Server, which is by default attached with the your Windows systems with Microsoft. And another is there, that is the Apache. For Apache, what you do, you go for the all-in-one, what I have given, that is the XAMPP. And it has special version also, WAMP, that is Ubuntu version, and LAMP, that is the Linux version. But don't confuse for this WAMP, LAMP at this moment. You just go for the XAMPP. So I am using Windows 10 operating system, and it is a 64-bit operating system. Just go to the website what I have given, www. Other, or you go to how to download and install XAMPP with for this and these things in Google. It will show you all the things. Then you download. After downloading, right click and run as a administrator. And all on the screen, whatever things are there, you just check it, and you can install. Because you as computer science guys and you are in final year, I should not tell you the procedure how to download and install. That part is not required for you. Maybe it is for mechanical skill people, maybe it will be required. For you, it is not required. Okay. So then what I want to say, you this is the way how we can write and how we can deploy. For writing, you see it is easy. Writing it is easy. So what you have written, the first line and the fourth line, it is the minimum syntax for PHP, and it can be in a single line also. Okay, there is nothing to worry. So less than question mark PHP, and at the end a question mark greater than, this is all about PHP. So total PHP is just two words. The first word is from this point to this point, and the second word is from this point to this point. And after that, what you write, all stories, it will run. There is no issue. Okay, you are declaring a variable start with the dollar sign, and after this equal sign, whatever you put it under double quotation, at the end put a semicolon. Okay, similarly for echo, because it echo is just like the printing option for that one. Echo, and there is no equal to sign here. Just put it on double quotation. So whatever the content, I love your writing. I study in also. I study in instead of love. I study in. Okay, back. I study in dollar text. Okay, control S. Then you run this program, and the output will come. I study in. Now I refresh. That time it was not running, but it will run. I study in BBC Engineering College. Okay. So like that you can do. So we have successfully run three programs. One is the program PH1, second is PH2, third one is the PH3. Okay, so in the first program, it is a general program I have given you how to display something. The second program, I have told you how to write the single line comments, how to write the multiple line comments, how to declare a variable, and how to use the variable inside this program. Okay, these are the things that should be clarity with you, and you have to remember all the things, because gradually will increase day by day, more number of contents will increase. And you, if it is possible, you install and practice all the things also, because simply listening and forgetting, it is of no use to you, me, or the institution. So you, what you listen here now, the same thing you note down in a notebook, and same thing you practice with your system. Clear? Then I go for the next program, say then file, then I go for open the file, I go for the program 4. Okay, so my program 4, it is here, ps4, ps4.psv, open. So this is my things. Here I am going to use a function. How do I use a function inside the PSP? Okay, I told you that first 3 lines, it is of no use, you write, don't write, there is no difference. If you want a proof also, I will delete in front of you. Similarly, the last 2 lines also, because I am writing all the things inside the HTML, that's all. There is no use for this thing. So if the PSP program starts here, less than question mark PSP, and ends here. Then I declare a function. What is the function name? The syntax is like this, function space, what is the function name? And it is within the parentheses. Then you start the curly braces here, curly bracket here. Then I have declared a variable x which is equal to 5. So it has a local scope. That means it will work inside this function. Let us see outside the function, if I call this variable x, whether it is giving an output. Then echo, I write a paragraph p, and variable x inside the function is something. Then what is that? That is dollar x. Dollar x means dollar x already defined 5. The output should come here 5. When it comes, when I call this function, what is my function name? My test. My test is the function. Okay, you understand what I'm telling you that? So for declaring a function inside the PHP, just declare function, and you give the function name. My function name is my test. You remember, when it is more than one word, the first letter of the second word must start with a capital letter. If it is a compound word of three words, then first letter of each word after the first word, it will be capital letter. That means, suppose my test case, then M will be lowercase, T will be capital case, and again C will be capital case. Like that, you have to do it there. Then you put it inside the braces. Then you start the curly bracket here and close it here. So this is the content of this function, whatever there. Now I am writing a variable x and assigning the value to 5. So I am writing a comment here. This is on the local scope here. And echo, I am writing variable inside the function is. So it will show $x. $x means it will show 5. Now when it will show, when I call this function my test, then it will show. Now outside the function, I am writing echo p variable x outside function is that. Whether it is showing the variable x then 5 here, that I have to check it there. Okay, I hope you understood the program here, or you have a look it here. This is the less than question mark PHP. I am declaring a function. The name of my function is my test. So it is starting with the function here, and it is starting with the curly braces. And here I am declaring a variable x and assigning a value to 5. And after that, a semicolon, because something it is to be displayed, that I put it here, that I want to display that variable x. Okay, then I put a semicolon. The p just like a paragraph, because to use this p, you need to use this HTML, because the p tag only the HTML will understand. That is the reason I am writing this HTML here. Then here also I am using the same p tag, variable x outside the function, because the function you called it here. So this is the function you declared it here, and you are calling it here. And this part, what is that? This is outside the function, not inside the function. And this scope, what I have declared it here, this variable, it is a local scope. So outside the function, it is, because what is the meaning of a variable? What is the variable I am declaring? After that execution, the value will be gone. Nothing will be stored there. Remember that. So in that case, if you want to store it there, then you have to use another word, some static word or some global word, something like that. That I will talk later. Okay. Now let us run this program. So this is the program number 4. So we are going to our local host. You see here, local host colon 8080 slash. It was ps3.php. Now I back and make it 4 PSP, ps4.php. Why I'm writing ps like this? No, see, variable x inside function is 5, because it is the local scope and you are calling inside the function. Notice undefined variable x in y because outside I have not defined that variable. So this is the variable defined inside the function. That is the reason outside it is not returning any value. It is showing it is error. Some problem is there on defined variable x in this on the line number 11. So in this program ph4.php the program name, in this folder htdocs, inside this main root folder jam, inside the directory c, and in this program on line number 13 there is a error. What is that error in line number 13? Let us see. What is the line number 13? Line number 13 here, that variable I am calling, it is only inside the function. So that means if you need this variable to be declared here, then you have to declare here outside or somewhere. You got it? So that is the reason it is showing there is no value here for that one. It's clear? I hope this is the thing. Another one small program I will run now. Now let us go for one more program. This is the program number 4. I am going for program number 5. File open. You go for the program 5 or ph5.php. Okay. ph5.php. Open this program. Okay. Now, see, I told you that if you want to use this function, if you use this variable outside this function, then you have to declare it here. Suppose I have declared here x is equal to 5, variable x 5, and variable y is equal to 10. Okay, here I am using it global variable dollar x and dollar y, and dollar y is equal to dollar x plus dollar y, that is in variable x and y. When I am going for mind test here, because the name of this function is mind test, then what will show the output here? Output it will show 5 plus 10 is equal to 15. Then again I am asking echo dollar y. What is the dollar y? Let us see this program. On this program the output will be 15 also. Okay, the output will be 15 also. Okay, this is program number 5. Go to the program here and run this program number, sorry, go to the thing, right, not it. Yeah, here, run to the program back 5, and it is also showing 15. Okay, yeah, so this is the PS4. Okay, say suppose I put it under this double quotations, what will happen? Let me see. Say put it here. Okay, go here and go to the program number 5. Suppose I put it under this double quotations, what will happen? So double quotation, then I put the double quotation here also, and I suppose I control S and I run this program, what will happen? Same output, there is no change. Okay, so now you have understood that whenever, because you see I am using the global variable here, that is dollar x and dollar y, so it is used inside this one, it is also used outside, there is no problem, the output will be the same. Okay, okay, suppose I don't want to use this file, just put to forward slash this one. Okay, now let us see what is the output. Control s. Okay, cancel, then you come to this program here and come here and run this program. They are not showing any output here. Okay, so now, yeah, now so you have to write this program, sorry, yeah, enter. Now the output will come. Okay, now control S, run this program. Now you can get the output. Yeah, PS5. Okay, the output is 15. Clear? So in similar fashion, you can write a number of program. You can also practice a number of program here. So this was the program number 5. If you are interested, you can see one more program here also. So file, open file. Suppose I want to go for the program number 6. So you just go for the PH6. Sorry. Yeah, where it is? Yeah. This is PH6.php. This is the program number 6. What is the content you see here? You see, I told you that when you declare a variable, so long as you are using it is okay. And once the execution is over, whatever you assign to that variable, it is gone. So for that, if you want to remember that one, then you have to use the word static keyword. Okay. For example, so okay, without this, what will happen? Let me see. Without static, what will happen? Let me see. Suppose I use it double sign here, then Control C, enter, Control V. So this is my program say. What I've defined? I have defined a variable X and assigned it 0. Then equal dollar X, something it will come. Then I am going for dollar X plus plus. That means it has to you have to go for increment. Then I am calling this function 3 times. My test, this is the name of the function. You can write any name. I have written my test. Okay. Then what should be the output here? Anybody can guess and tell me. What should be the output? Okay. Now let us run this program and see the output. Okay. Now this is the program number. I think this is the program number 6. So this is the program number back 6. Enter. The program number 6 it is. Okay, 012. It has shown. Okay, this part shift I control X. I put it here. Suppose control V. Okay, control S. And I run this program. What is the output? Undefined variable in X. This is the undefined variable in X. So all 3 times it is not recognizing anything. Okay. So now what do we need to do? Yeah. So control Z, control Z, control Z, control Z, control Z, control Z. Okay. Now I am using the static keyword. So with this, what will happen? So I am declaring the variable X and initializing to 0. Now echo dollar X. So what will show? It will show 0. Now it is going for the increment X plus plus. Okay. But so if I'm calling this function my test, but in the first one will be 0. Then I'm calling the my test again, then it will go for the increment and it will show 1. Then I'm calling the my test function again, then it will increase and go for the increment, it will show the 2. So that is the thing I want to use. So for you want the variable to store and remember the value, then we have to use the static keyword. Okay. That is all about this today's class. And I this video lecture also I'll be uploading to you through the YouTube. And I'm requesting all to share with your friends, because I know some of the people they are with the impression that during this corona time there will be no university exam and all people automatically will get passed. This is the wrong thing. See, this is a I do not know this is the rumor with you. The thing is that now you are promoted and you have to write this university exam most probably in the month of August. Don't confuse you that your exam is exempted for the time being. Government has no alternate, so he has or promoted you all. But your exam will be conducted, and for this semester what you are studying, university exam is a mandatory, and you have to come and write physically all these things. Remember. So if you are thinking that by not attending the classes or by simply enjoying, so you will get a pass, so that is not possible. Okay. So I am requesting you all to share this video with your friends and go through this video and download and install this program. At the same time also you try to implement yourself. If you get any doubt or any query, you would be free to send me mail or SMS. You can also like, dislike, you can give your comments there also. I'll be happy to receive some comments. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. Take care of all. कौन बंद करी थी गुड्डू?